Hi students, in this video I'll be sharing with you some of the important tips when answering 1123 O level English language paper 1 section 2 composition. As what all of you are aware, in this section 2 there will be two topics given under argumentative and two under narrative, but only one under descriptive. So first of all, try to read these topics at least twice before choosing which type of writing that would be best to be answered for that particular paper. And apart from that, you need to also choose your topic according to your strength and also your preparation, because you need to write about 350 to 500 words. And apart from that, always remember, when it comes to argumentative writing, one would be basically focusing more on argumentative style, and the other one would be more on discursive. I'll be sharing about this in the next video, but let's move on with the next tip. Now, apart from that, always remember that you need to always plan your writing, and you need to always recheck your work. And I'm just going to share with you how you can actually manage the time. So it's about you're planning your response, you can take about 8 minutes, 7 to 8 minutes, and writing you need to spend about 45 minutes, and it's very important for you to proofread. That means you need to edit for punctuation, or you need to check your grammar, your sentence structure, your vocabulary. So all this you need to spend at least 5 to 6 minutes. So always remember that when you're writing a descriptive and argumentative essay, you need to have a proper introduction. So you need to have one paragraph for the introduction, and maybe for the detailed body paragraph you can have about 3 to 6, and then you can have a very logical conclusion for about maybe one paragraph. And if you are writing a narrative essay, make sure that their stories should have a very engaging opening. And you know, you need to really make sure that you can sustain the reader's interest, and there should be a logical ending and also a proper resolution. So when it comes to narrative, always use a good plot. That means you need to have an introduction to your story, you need to write the action, but before you write the action, you need to find for conflict, and then you need to do a very good climax, and then you need to have a falling action before you finally end your story. So always keep your stories realistic and believable. You can always use some other techniques like flashback, you can use dialogue, you can use a description of setting in order to make your narrative composition be more engaging with your readers. And always remember, don't die at the end of the story, or don't just say that it's a bad dream. Because if you have been giving a really good plot, and your readers are, or I mean your readers who are the examiners, are pretty much excited reading your story, and at the end of the story and they just realize that it was a bad dream. So I would not say that. I would say that it's not really a very good style of ending your story. And please do not die at the end of the story. If you are writing this as a first person point of view, if you are dead, then who's telling the story? Okay, now apart from that, it is also very important for you to refrain from showing violence, racism, or you ended up coming up with something, I mean glorifying crime in your stories, because remember that you are writing it for academic purpose. And it's also important that you need to edit your essay for certain grammatical errors. That means your basic punctuation, even that apostrophe S could change the overall idea. That means from it's without apostrophe and it's with apostrophe. So you need to also try to use some ambitious vocabulary. You can use ambitious vocabulary unless you are extremely confident about it. So, but if you feel that you do not really have a right choice of word to explain the particular idea, then you can actually use simple words correctly, which is more appropriate. And I would say that Instead of using something which you do not know just to impress the examiner, you can basically use the existing words that you have in order to convey your ideas clearly, precisely, and accurately. So these are some of the important tips and techniques that I would like to share with you. So see you again in the next video.